Right, so I'm going to use this board. So the first, what we're actually doing is we're doing CRISPR, and I mentioned we were doing CRISPR, and that is essentially we're editing the genes of some E. coli. Wait, this is no, that is the wrong.
Don't worry.
Okay. It's the pen that they use to draw on the vials, not to draw on the board.
I should have said something.
You should have said, no, it's entirely my fault in every shape. We can probably use some of this whiteboard solution. It comes off from the whiteboard solution, yeah.
Great. No, I'm still pulling.
Right, so, we have a plate of... Yeah, sorry about that. Right, so we have a plate of E. coli that we're actually going to be using as our organism. And what E. coli has the ability to do is digest lactose. Like E. coli can generally digest the sugar lactose. So let's say the lactose looks a bit like this, right? It doesn't because it's a disaccharide, but let's pretend this is what lactose is. And normally, they have a special gene in their DNA. So let's say this is a bit of their DNA, and this is the gene they want. And this part of the gene is called LacZ. Right, so what LacZ does is it codes for the production of an enzyme, and that enzyme is the thing that breaks down lactose. So what we're actually going to do is the main aim of the experiment is to break this gene and stop it from making the enzyme, and therefore it can no longer digest lactose. We're trying to do that, right? So that's the point of the experiment. First thing we've got to do is figure out how we can tell it's digesting the lactose in the first place. So if it's just digesting lactose, we're not going to know, so we're not going to see the results. So one way that they've done this, what we're going to be doing here, is taking this complex called XGAL. XGAL is not actually lactose. It's lactose added to this extra blue pigment. So it's a lactose molecule that's been added to this sort of bromo, iodo, weird, long-named compound. And that comes this big complex called XGAL. And essentially what this does is it's similar enough to lactose, right? It has a bit that looks like lactose. And that means, let's say this is the enzyme that comes along, that the bacteria has made, and it's gonna be able to eat the lactose part of it, but it can't eat this part of it, because that's not lactose. So what's gonna happen is it's gonna get broken off, and then you're gonna get the XGAL floating around in our solution. And because it's blue, this is a blue compound, when it's attached to the lactose, it isn't blue, because it's got a different chemical structure, so it's slightly changed, making this a white compound. But when it's separated on its own, it suddenly becomes blue. So essentially what we want to do is make it so that we can stop the enzymes from being able to do this. So we want to stop them from being able to make the enzymes and keep it in the white compound. Right, so if they can do this lactose, it's going to go blue. The natural state is for the bacteria to be able to make this go on its own and become blue. But if we get edited properly, they won't be able to make these, and the compound will stay as it is, and we're going to have a white agar plate. And that is what we're going to be doing with the CRISPR. So the real question is, there's a lot of extra stuff we've got to add to it to be able to make that possible. So first of all, what we need to do is we need to have the scissors, the molecular scissors, the actual Cas9 enzyme itself. This is the most important part of it. And let's say this is the Cas9 enzyme. And all this does, it doesn't do anything, it doesn't find the DNA, it doesn't match the DNA, all this does is it actually cuts the DNA.
Did somebody win the Nobel Prize for CRISPR?
I did, 2016, Jennifer Doudna and partner won the Nobel Prize for discovering the enzyme itself. And interestingly, it had been like known about in bacteria a while before that. It was an immune defense against viruses, but they only managed to engineer the right Cas9 enzyme and use it for their purposes recently. So this is quite a recent thing. Which is why it's quite cool to do now. We have the scissors. All that does is actually perform the double strand break, perform the break in the DNA. It doesn't do anything else. So what we also need is we need to add it to this little thing here. Everything I'm drawing in circles, but this little thing here is a plasmid of DNA. And this plasmid of DNA needs to contain the stuff that we want to add. Because the thing is, you might think that if we just go into the cell and we cut the genome, and suddenly this gene that used to make an enzyme is now cut in half, we've done our job. Because you might think that it can't make the enzyme anymore, the cell will not be able to make lactase, it won't be able to break it down into a blue compound, and then we'll have a white compound. But that's not actually what happens, because cells have this sort of system where they check the integrity of their DNA, and if they find a break, they'll just explode. They kill themselves, they do apoptosis. So this doesn't actually work. I mean, what this does is it just kills the cell, and it won't make a cell that can't make lactose, it'll just make a bunch of dead cells. That's not what we want to do. What we want is make them not be able to make the lactase. So instead we do is we break it first, and then we fill it back in, we repair it with some non-functioning version of the gene. right? So we knock out the gene and we fill it in with a broken version. That's what we're actually doing. And the thing is, we need the special system which fills in the genes to be working. Because this in cells, they have a system called HDR, homology-directed repair. There are a bunch of different ways they can repair their DNA. Once they see a break, they're going to be trying to repair it as soon as possible. Usually they use NHEJ, which is non-homology-directed end joining, and we're not going to talk about that, but these E. coli are very good at doing HDR. And they can only do HDR in the presence of this special compound called arabinose, which we've got over there. So let's say we have to add arabinose in here as well, so we have to add a bunch of stuff in here. And that means that we've cut it, and the arabinose allowed it to be replaced with the broken version of the genome, which is here, right? So we have all the ingredients now. But also, we need one more ingredient. We need the guide RNA. Because right now, there is no way of this Cas9 enzyme knowing where it's going to make the cut. It's not just going to go around the DNA randomly cutting things. It has to localize straight into the Lex Z gene and make a cut right there, and that allows us to fill it in with the broken version. So it has to have a way of recognizing the right DNA. So it has this thing called guide RNA. And the guide RNA, we put in the complex here, we add it here. But what it actually does is it quickly attaches to the Cas9 enzyme in a special like sort of site on the Cas9 enzyme, and it makes a complex with the guide RNA. And then this thing will go around the cell, looking until it finds a bit of DNA called a PAM sequence that is compatible with the guide RNA. So it will find this, and because it's a very specific sequence, it will recognize part of the DNA here, and that will take the scissors into the right place. Without this guide RNA, it would be looking forever. But this allows it to find the right place to be compatible, and it allows it to stick to the genome. So that's really, really useful. Now we've got a way of the scissors getting to the right place, and then once the scissors are here, they will perform double strand break here, and it'll break it up, then you'll get the HDR enzyme to come in, attach this donor template, and the HDR enzyme comes in, and then sticks the right broken gene back in place. So it's actually a lot harder than you'd originally think. When we're actually making it, we're gonna make four plates. We're not just gonna make one working plate, because we wanna actually see it in action. So we're gonna make four different plates, and only one of them will be able to work. Here, at IX Ara here, this means that we have arabinose in this plate. So arabinose has already been cultured in with these bacteria. So this doesn't have any arabinose. And you can already tell, only these ones are gonna be able to work. Here, you're never gonna be able to repair the DNA. Only here is it gonna be able to function. So we're only testing these just for the sake of it. If you put it in with the cutter and with the donor, what are we missing? We're missing the guide, right? We can't find the DNA, nothing happens. It can't even cut anything. Here, you have the Cas, the donor, and the guide. It can find the right place, it makes the cut, but lo and behold, there's no arabinose. It can't repair the cell. They die. There's no growth. And not only does it not work, but they all die because they explode because they have broken DNA. So that's terrible. Now, when we put the arabinose here, great, everything, uh-oh, no guide. We still can't do anything. It's still blue. Only in this final plate, which has the arabinose, the guide, and the Cas9, and the donor, we'll be able to make a functioning gene-edited bacteria. And we've made the agar plates. So agar is where we're going to culture the bacteria on. Now, we've made the agar, but we don't actually have any bacteria on it. So our job today is to rehydrate the bacteria so we can put it on the plates tomorrow. So first step, we have this LB broth. which is part of the sugars that we use in the agar, and it's going to help bacteria survive. And what we do now is we take a sterile pipette tip and we put 250 microliters, which we use the micropipette for, and we put that in the, put that much LB broth into the vial of lyophilized E. coli. All right, that just shouldn't be too hard if I can open this. Why is everything in biology so hard to open? So, Pokemon's just house. Wait, they're already on. No, they're not. That goes on there. I have to do this very quickly as well because we're being a bit risky because we haven't got a flame. So, we're supposed to have flames, but Anna said it's fine. Ben, can you help me put this on? Why isn't this going on?
That's
going
to go to air.
Oh, wait, now it's going on. Oh, and as a precaution, we're supposed to reboil this once in the microwave and then tighten the cap and then basically now we're supposed to reboil this, so pause the video. Right, so this is slightly scary because it says for each of the 8 workstations, label 2 milliliter tubes the following. So basically we have all these tubes now and it's gonna take a while. What we're gonna do is we're gonna put different combinations of these two solutions in each of the tubes, getting ready for us to put the actual CRISPR DNA in. So once we've done that, we're gonna put the CRISPR DNA in and then you can all see that. Stop recording, this is gonna take a while. Why are these different sizes?
What are you doing?
I'm actually adding 1.2 milliliters of transformation solution to each of... Oh wait, as you can see, I've labelled all the stations.
Yeah, I know.
Painstakingly labelled all the tubes.
We did the montage.
And I'm sorry, I forgot. So some of them are called TS, standing for transformation solution, which it... Oh God, it's so cold, which is this thing. I'm sorry. I'm actually not one of... This is one of the only things that I'm not 100% sure what it does. It contains calcium chloride. And if anyone can tell me why we need that, I'm sure that would be useful.
This is how it's done. This is how it's usually done. They do a jump cut, but not us.
1.2 milliliters, is that? I mean, does it matter? That is as close as I'm gonna get. Right, TS.
Does it matter?
Boom. This is going great. I figured out how
to do this. For all of them?
For all 8,
This is another montage.
Are you gonna video me doing all 8? Because that's insufferable.
Right, so I've done these 4.
No, liquid.
I've done these 4.
Transformers and see what the results are. This can be a long-term project, so we're going to start doing it in Biosoft probably next week because I've taken up so many. But I don't see why we can't like do it more times. I mean, we've made everything that we need. So.
Don't try not to breathe on these because you'll get contamination. What the hell's wrong with this microphone? I think there's nothing left in it. I mean, that one's not supposed to work anyways.
Who's gonna know? Right, this is plasma donor guys, because we want it to work. So I'll get plasma donor guys, right here. It's in here. And we're meant to have a truth.
I was going to see you very bad.
Okey dokes. That should work. That, if that goes white soon, I will be very, very happy.
So we'll put this one.
These look like they might be dying, you know.
What are we calling?
We shouldn't be. These should be.
What are we calling this one?
Did you?
Did you?
Yeah.
That's the same as this one.
Yeah, because it's Arab. So,
huh?
It's Arab nose and only bad, so it should work.
Why will this one work? But this one not work.
This one has Arab nose, so it allows for the promotion of the expression of the HDR enzymes.
Okay.
So the HDR enzymes are going to repair the DNA hole. Here it will repair. Here it won't.
Have we done everything we're going to do for today?